So after talking with Mr. Munro, Holmes formed one theory that was his provisional theory, means for official purpose it could be used, means it's just a theory he had made. What was his theory? He said that yes, a provisional one. The fact is, as I read them, are something like this. So now Holmes started describing that what fact he wanted to say. This woman was married in America. Her husband contracted some disease. So this lady, according to Holmes, this was Holmes' theory, okay? According to this theory, that this woman was married in America. Her husband contracted, means her husband was attacked by some disease. She fled from him, returned to England. So she just came to England, escaping from him. She changed her name and started her life afresh, in a fresh manner. She had been married 3 years and believed that her position was secure. So she was married for 3 years. She thought that her position was secure. And having shown her husband the death certificate of some man whose name she had assumed. So she had shown a false death certificate name whom she had made to her husband. When suddenly her whereabouts was discovered by her first husband. When suddenly her whereabouts means whatever was her place. Was discovered by her first husband. Means her first, she escaped from her first husband and came to married here with the second husband, and she showed the false death certificate to the second husband, and somehow where she was staying, what she was doing became public, and came to her first husband came to know all these things. When suddenly her whereabouts were discovered by her first husband or by some unscrupulous woman who had attached herself to him, so, or by some dishonest woman who had been tracking Effie to blackmail her. Means this man, this woman was a common link between Effie's first husband and her. They write to the wife and threaten to come and expose her. So they had written to the wife and they wanted to expose her, everything. That is, she had escaped from her first husband. She asked for £100 to buy them out. So she wanted to buy those men and she asked for £100. They come in spite of it, and when the husband mentions to the wife that they are newcomers in the cottage, she knows that they are her pursuers. So what happened? She knows that she found that some newcomers were there in the cottage. She knows that they were her followers. She waits until her husband is asleep and then tries to persuade them to leave her in peace. So she waited till her husband was asleep. Then she went to the cottage and she tried to convince those followers who had followed her to leave her in peace. Having no success, she goes again next morning. So she did not have any success. She went there next morning. Her husband meets her as she comes out. So when she was coming out in the next morning, her husband met her. So she promises him then not to go there again. She promised to her husband that she would not go there again. But 2 days afterwards, she makes another attempt, taking with her the photograph which had probably been demanded from her. So after 2 days, she again made the mistake because she took her photograph and again she went to meet the persons who were probably following him and who probably demanded the photo from her. She warns him at night, he might go to the cottage. He does go but finds the place deserted. What do you think of my theory? Now, she warned the inmates of the house, means those who have been staying in the house, that Mr. Munro would come to the house and go to the cottage. The man did that, but finds the place deserted. But he found what? That the place deserted. No one was there in that place. What do you think of my theory? It's all surmise. And this man told what? That it was all guesswork. Whatever, what do you think about my theory? Means this was the total story made by Sherlock Holmes. So Sherlock Holmes framed one story and told to Dr. Watson. And then he asked Dr. Watson, what did he think about his theory? It's all surmise. Dr. Watson replied that it was all guess. But at least it covers all the facts. So it was all guess. Though Sherlock Holmes had guessed everything, but it was covering everything. At present, we can do nothing until we have a message. So at that time, they could not do anything until they would get a message from Mr. Munro. But we had not very long to wait. It came after tea. The cottage was still tenanted. It said, I will meet in the 7 o'clock train. So after the tea, the message was received by them that the tenants were still there in the cottage. And also Mr. Munro requested them to go there by the 7 o'clock train. He was waiting on the platform when we stepped out. So he was waiting on the platform when they stepped out. He was very pale and quivering with agitation. He was very angry and just trembling with fear. And he was very pale. They were still there, Mr. Holmes said. I saw lights in the cottage as I came down. So he pointed out that they were still there, Mr. Holmes said. And he had seen the lights in the cottage as he came down. What is your plan then? Asked Mr. Holmes. So asked at that point of time, Holmes asked that what was his plan. I am going in. I wish you both to be there as witness. So he was so angry. He was ready to go inside the cottage. And he said that Dr. Watson and Sherlock Holmes would be staying there as witnesses. It was a very dark night. As you could understand, a thin rain began to fall. So there was a thin rain falling. As we turned from the high road into a narrow lane. Mr. Grant Munro pushed forward. Mr. Grant Munro just forcibly went forward. He stumbled after him. Means he was running in such a speed that Holmes and Dr. Watson was just falling following him. We turned to the corner of the lane and there was this building. The door was not quite closed. We approached the door, but suddenly a woman appeared and stood in the golden track of the lamplight. Her arms were thrown out in an attitude of entreaty. So they just turned into the corner of the lane and they could see the building. The door was not quite closed. The door was half open. As they approached the door, suddenly what happened? The door was opened and the light was falling. On the way of the light, they could see that a lady or a woman was appearing and she was just standing right in front of the door. And she had thrown her arms in such a way, it seemed that she was trying to request something. For God's sake, don't, Jack, she cried. I thought that you would come. Think better of it, dear. Trust me. So she again told Jack, means Mr. Munro, means that lady was Effie, and she again told Mr. Munro not to go inside, and she wanted him to trust her again, and she told that he should not do it because it would be very much painful for both of them.